Hey guys, what is up? So if you do not know who I am, hi, my name is Mansi and this is my YouTube channel. So actually this is my mic, I mean those are my earphones. I'm using my earphone mic for this video and I hope the audio is fine. I'm sorry if there's any issue because I was getting a few comments on my previous videos from you guys that the audio quality was not that good. So I'm just trying to, you know, fix it a little bit. So yeah, now that's that. If you guys have clicked on this video, you already know that today's video is very different and interesting, I guess. So to be very honest with you guys, I am a little bit nervous for today's video. As you can already see, I am a little nervous. It is not easy for me to talk about the stuff that I'm about to talk to you guys. And I have nothing planned on what I'm gonna say and what is gonna happen in today's video. I am just gonna sit and talk my heart out. That's all that is gonna happen. I'm sorry if I offend anyone in this video. I hope not. I don't think so. That's gonna be a problem, but just in case, I apologize. Also, I'm pretty sure today's video is gonna be a pretty long, but I'm not gonna try and keep it short either. I'm just going to speak my heart out. So I have been wanting to make a video talking about my whole skinny shaming journey since a year now. I've always, you know, been neglecting it and, you know, just pushing it away. I don't know why, but today I was just like, you know what, I'm gonna do it. Also, by any means, I'm not trying to victimize myself. I'm not saying that, oh my god, I'm the only one who goes through all of that, blah blah blah. No, that's not me. Even in my personal life, I never really do that. So this is just me sharing my story, and I know a lot of you guys have been through the same things that I am gonna share with you. My goal here with this video is just to reach as many people as possible and inspire them. So now, all that said, let's just get into it. So when I was like a baby, I was born as a super healthy kid. As I was growing up, I was becoming a lot more skinnier and skinnier. So just letting you guys know, I do not think that I have any eating disorder or anything. I do eat a lot. I do eat a lot. But in my case, it's genetic. My parents were a lot skinny when they, you know, got married. And so was my mom, and so is my brother. Like, he was, and now that he is 24, as he grew up, he put on a lot of weight. So that's how my genetics work. So going back to the past, so as I was growing up, I was very skinny and I used to dance a lot. I was a lot into sports and activities. I used to play outdoor games a lot. So it wasn't like I was very weak growing up. I wasn't weak, I was just skinny. I had all that energy. I had a lot of energy. And growing up, I've always gotten comments from my relatives and my friends in school and stuff that, oh my god, you're so skinny. They used to, you know, hold my wrist and just to be like, oh my god, look at your wrist. Freaking annoying, to be honest. But yeah, that used to happen. And back then I had a lot of temper issues. I don't know, maybe it was because of this reason, but I did have a lot of temper issues. And if in school anyone commented on how skinny I was, I used to backlash at them, and I used to literally start up a fight with them. I don't know, that's just how I was back then. And yeah, I used to get like really, really offended if anyone spoke anything about my body, and I did not like it. When I was in my 8th, 9th or 10th grade, I used to just feel bad. I used to go and I start crying. So I remember I used to go for these tuition classes, and there was this one girl, she still follows me by the way. So she was there standing down with two of her friends. We had just gotten done with our classes, and I got down and she was like, are you malnourished? And like, how are you so skinny? Do you even eat food and all of that? I went home and I felt like so bad. I was just crying the whole freaking time. At this point, I just didn't feel anger. I was just sad the whole time. I used to just cry. I remember once I was in college, I think so 11th grade, and I was waiting at the bus stop, and a bus came, and there were two guys sitting in the bus. And this one guy looked at me and he called his other friend and he looked at me and they both was just laughing at me. Now at this point, I didn't even know if they were laughing because I'm skinny, but my brain was so washed, I think so. But everything that happened in my life, I thought it was because I was skinny. Like the smallest thing. If I'm walking on the road and if anyone just looks at me, my brain is to automatically be like, oh my God, that person is looking at me because I'm so thin and like, that person is judging me. So at this point, I had brainwashed myself completely by overthinking and it was not a nice thing. It had affected my confidence totally. Like, let me tell you, it had crushed my confidence to absolute zero. Absolute zero. It was like a huge deal for me to even step out of my house and, you know, go in public. And public places scared me to death. And then this one time I remember I was going to my friend's place and I got down the auto and this auntie that I don't even freaking know, she comes to me and she's like, beta, ab kuch khate nahi ho, aapko khana chahiye, kitna patli ho. I do not even know this lady, okay, but still she had to come all the way, like literally she was walking and she had to come all the way after looking at me and she had to comment on my body. That's great. Aunties, those species of aunties are awesome. I absolutely hate them. And this one time I was again going to college and I was with my friend Vedanti, I think so. Yeah, and we were in the bus and back then I was wearing like those skinny leggings which were like super trending when Forever 21 had come out, like, you know. So I was wearing those leggings and I was wearing a top. And we were supposed to get down for a stop and we both stood up and I was standing. So this lady calls my friend and she said something to her and I was like, okay, whatever. And after we got down, my friend tells me that the lady was telling my friend to tell me that not to wear skinny clothes because not to wear tight clothes because they do not really look good on my body type. Literally this lady who doesn't even know me had to call my friend and ask her to tell me to not wear such clothes. Can you imagine? Like, I do not even get how the thought process of these people even work. Even in school, if like teacher asked any question and I knew the answer to that, I would never, you know, raise my hand and answer it just because I didn't want to stand and I didn't want the whole class looking at me because again they would be like so skinny. So those were the things that really, really affected me and my confidence was so low, dude, you have no idea. Then I remember it was my school farewell and we all had to wear saris and I was so excited. My mom literally stitched the sari for me and yeah, I was wearing the sari and we were just, you know, hanging out. We were just all hanging out, eating our stuff. There were these two teachers who were sitting there and they looked at me, they're literally pointing at me and they're talking about like how skinny I was. That hurt so bad. I felt so bad. My mood was like super off the whole freaking time after that. So some of you guys must be thinking, oh my God, Mansi, these are just small petty things. No, they are not. When these things keep happening, they just keep adding and adding and adding up and it just makes the worst feeling ever. I had lost literally so many great opportunities because of this. I mean, because of my confidence that I just didn't want to be in front of people. I literally lost a lot of great opportunities which I'm like, I shouldn't have. And also, to be honest, mom, dad and my brother, if you are watching this, I remember this one time I was dressed up and I was about to head out and I opened the lift and my brother was coming at home and I was supposed to go down and he was like, you look at you or something like that. He just made a face and I literally cried and it felt so bad. BRB. Okay guys, sorry about that. Let's move on. So thankfully I've had like some amazing friends who have never let me down. Those were the people in front of whom I didn't have to, you know, hide myself. I could always be you know, the real me in front of those people. And also, I'm not one of those people who have, like, you know, tons of friends. I have, like, very limited friends. Like, literally, I could count them on my 10 fingers. And I'm so damn grateful for them. If you're watching this, I love you guys. Now, fast forward to my present. Getting over this whole confidence thing was the most hardest thing I ever had to do in my life. Actually, I have to do in my life because it's still ongoing in process. I still have to push myself to even start a conversation with anyone. I have honestly fought so many silent battles just by myself. I have prepared myself mentally to go and, you know, push myself and do that stuff which my whole mind and my confidence is telling me not to do. I had to really, really push myself. And I'm not afraid, and I'm not going to refrain from saying that I'm really proud of myself for where I am right now. Like, even sitting in front of this camera and talking to you takes me a lot of efforts. So if you are someone who has been through what I have been through, you can do it. I just want to know that you can do it. You just have to push yourself. It's just that little push that you have to give yourself to, you know, get at the level of confidence that you deserve and that you have always wanted. Right now, I'm at a point of my life where I still do get a lot of comments about, oh my god, you're so thin, do you even eat, how are you so skinny? I still get that at work, I get it everywhere. But the difference is that it doesn't get to me, and I'm not even just saying it for saying sake. It really doesn't get to me. And now if anyone comes and tells me, oh my god, you're so thin, I just say thank you. I don't know what the intentions are, good or bad, but I'm just gonna take it as a compliment either way, because I am skinny, I love the way how I look, and I wanna embrace it, and I take it as a compliment. So, joke's on you. Just know that you don't have to go through it, dude. You can change it, like, right now. Just start taking small steps, and that's what will lead you to what you really deserve. And every time someone called me, like, you know, skinny or something, my friends always told me, oh, just ignore it, it's not a big deal, you know you're beautiful, just ignore it. I cannot. Like, I know people say that, and I know it's, like, good intention of saying it, but you cannot just ignore it, dude. Like, even if you want to, you cannot just ignore it. Especially when you're at the lowest confident self of yourself. I don't even know what am I saying, it's making any sense, but this is like the realest this video can get. Is realist even a word? No, it's not. It still takes me a lot of you know, effort and convincing myself to wear sleeveless outside. I know it is a long journey. I still have a long way to go and building my confidence up. And again, as I said before, it's one step at a time. You do not have to force yourself. Just, you know, it's a little push that you need, and you will be the only person to give it to yourself. And if anything, at worst, if you're feeling like really low, you can always hit me up in my DM, because every time I get a DMs or emails like these, I do reply to you guys, and I try to help you guys out and, you know, motivate you. And I'm still every day doing a little things to, you know, build my confidence up and build my personality, shape my personality, because I'm not gonna let those people who said bad things to me like years ago get to me, because they probably don't even remember it. So why should I, you know? I do not even know how long this video is at this point, but I just sat and I shared my experience with you guys. And if I said anything wrong, I probably don't even know, because I was just speaking my heart out. But I'll know of it when I edit the video. But just know that you do not have to go through what you are going through right now. You can always fix it. And yeah, and I also really hope that I inspired at least one of you guys to, you know, push yourself to become a better version of yourself. This is my first ever sit down video. Let me know if you guys have enjoyed it, because I really enjoy making it. So yeah, I think I'll see you guys in my next video. Till then, stay beautiful always.